नमस्ते स्टूडेंट्स, माय नेम इज जेवियंस डॉक्टर नीरज धोलिया, फैकल्टी ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर एंड वेटरनरी साइंस, ज्योति विद्यापीठ, वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी, जयपुर। तो इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द रेजिस्टेंट टू फायरोजेनेटिक चेंजेस एंड दिस बिलोंग्स टू द सब्जेक्ट बिहेवियरल साइंस। ओके, सो इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर्स वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द सीरोटिपिक बिहेवियर and in the continuation we are here to discuss the next topic, that is the resistant to phylogenetic changes. Okay, so there was a scientist in 1809 to 1882, Charles Darwin, and he proposed two theories. One is the gradual evolutionary change by adaptive mutations, and second is the survival of the fittest. Okay, so what is the meaning of first theory, that gradual evolutionary change by adaptive radiations? Means all the species are gradually evolved. Evolution or development is there in all the species, and how the evolution is there? By the adaptive mutations. Means mutations are there. Okay, most of the mutations are harmful, but few of the mutations are beneficial. So if the mutations are harmful, if they are lethal, they will be eliminated themselves. Okay, and if the mutations is beneficial and it is according to the changing environment, it is adaptive, then it will be inherited or it will be fixed in its genetic makeup. So by adapting these type of the mutations, the currently surviving species will be evaluated, means they are developing. Second theory is the survival of the fittest, means in the current scenario or in the current environment, which is the best fit animal will survive and rest will be eliminated. Okay, so the adaptive mutations are helpful in the development of the species. Okay, so if an organism has a trait that provides a selective advantage, or selective advantage means if it is have the significance for the current scenario, the current environment, so the natural selection favor that specific organism. Okay, because what is the natural selection? Nature selects the best things. Okay, so the mutations are always there, and if through the adaptive mutations, if it is the provides a selective advantage to that organism, the that will be survived or that will be selected by the nature. So adaptive significance here refers to the expression of a trait that affects the fitness, the measured by the individual's reproductive success. Okay, so who is fit? Who is fit? So fit animal will survive longer, will reproduce and gives the progeny, and it will transfer its genes to the next generation. Okay, so in the fitness or in the adaptive significance, the nature think that if the individual is success in the reproduction, it is reproductively successful, then it is fit. Okay, so it is measured, the successful is measured by an individual's reproductive success. So adaptive traits are those that produce more copies of the individual's gene in future generations. So that is the adaptive trait that will be selected by the nature. Okay, so maladaptive traits are those that pure that leave pure, means if the trait have the adaptations, but the adaptations are not good or not well or not according to the environment, So that will be not survive longer. Okay, that will not transfer into next generations. So that is the it is not for the natural selection. Nature will not select those individuals. Okay. So for example, if a bird is there and that can call more loudly and attracts the other individuals of that species, that is favorable for it, because that the bird will loud call is an adaptive trait for that species, because a louder bird recognizes its members call it can call its members of its species, and that is necessary for the survival of that particular species or that particular trait, and of course for the reproduction and the continuation of its generation for the successive new species or new generations. Okay, so individuals are always in competition with others for the limited resources. The resources may be food, it may be the territories, it may be reproduction. Okay, so they always have the competition. The competition may be intra-species or inter-species. So intra-species competition will be for food, for territory, and for reproduction. And the inter-species competition will be for maybe for food and territories, not for reproduction. Okay. So in the competition, some individuals may help each other, and others may fight each other. Okay, so in that process, kin selection is the important process. So what is kin selection? We have studied the kin selection, or we have taken the introduction of the kin selection in the altruism. Okay, so what is altruism? So that is the individual take risk for the benefit of the other members of the species. That is the kin selection. Okay, so how he recognize that this is my kin? So that is the important thing to recognize. So now you are very well aware that what is the kin selection. It actually influences the survival and the reproduction of reproductive success of the genetically related individuals. That is known as the kin selection. So the kin selection, or the recognition of kin, is performed by two different methods. One is the genetic cues, and second is the environmental cues. So let's understand. So what is the genetic cues? So one possible method to kin selection is based on the genetic cues. So that is that can be recognized phenotypically. Okay, so if it is looking similar, then they think that this is my kin. So genetic recognition has been exemplified in a species that is usually not thought of as a social creature, like amoeba. Okay, social amoeba form fruiting bodies when starved for food. These amoeba preferentially form slugs and fruiting bodies with membranes of their own lineage, which is clonally related. Okay, so kin can also be recognized genetically determined odor, as studied in the primitively social sweet bee. Okay, so these bee can even recognize the relatives they have never met and roughly determine the relatedness. Okay, so next is for recognizing the kin is the environmental cues. So there are two simple rules that animals follow to determine who is kin. So what are the rules? These rules can be exploited but exist because they are generally successful. So these rules are very successful. First rule is treat anyone in my home as kin means this rule is readily seen in the reed warbler, a bird species that only focuses on chicks in their own nest. Means if you put a egg in the nest of the reed warbler. Reed warbler is a bird. Okay, so if you put an egg in the nest of the reed warbler, when the egg will hatch, so the bird, the parent bird, will recognize it as its own offspring. Okay, so it will consider it as a kin. So if its own kin is placed outside the nest, a parent bird ignore that chick. Okay, this rule can sometimes lead to odd results, specifically if there is a parasitic bird that lays egg in the reed warbler nest. So it will be give the odd results. So second result, second rule is named by a scientist that is known as the Conrad Lorenz, and gives the role as the imprinting, and it states that those who you grow up with are kin. Means imprinting is the example of the recognition of kin. Means the ducklings will recognize its the individuals or the objects which are present at the time of the hatching there as their parent. So that is the kin. Means at the time of their hatching, or when they are grow up, whatever the objects, whatever the animals are present there, that will be recognized as kin by that animal. Okay, so fine, that was all about the resistant to phylogenetic changes. And this in this lecture we have studied about the two theories of the Darwin, that is the gradual evolutionary change by the adaptive mutations and survival of the fittest. In this we have studied that what is the adaptive significance, what is the adaptive traits, what is the natural selection. Maladaptive traits will be removed, and we have understood by the examples what is the kin selection. That is the example of the altruism, and how to recognize the kin. There are two rules or two cues. One is the genetic cue, and second one is the environmental cue. Okay, so the environmental cue also explained. Okay, so fine, I think this is now clear to you, and hope you are satisfied with this digital session. If you have any query, you can write in the comment box. I will definitely reply, and I will resolve that issue. And this session is powered by Digital Version 2, Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University, Jaipur. Thank you.